Now let's consider what would happen if we had a cylindrical distribution of charge. I'm going to draw my convenient XYZ axis, not because it's part of the cylindrical coordinate system, but because it is convenient for me. And I'm going to consider a can without a top and a bottom. It's just the round part of the can. It's just an open cylinder. And let's suppose that it has a charge distribution rho s is equal to 7, let's say 7z coulombs per meter squared, which means that the higher up we go on the can, the higher the charge distribution. The can goes from 1 to 4 in the z direction, and it has a radius predefined as A. Any point out here on the can, the source point, can be defined as R is A, has some value phi, and it has some value z. So I'm going to do the same thing with this that I've done with all my other examples, and the first thing I'm going to do is draw a vector from the origin out here to the source point. All right, this vector has a distance from the origin out here to a cylindrical point. Remember, the easiest way to find a direction vector in cylindrical coordinates is to actually convert it to an x, a y, and a z term. All right, so what is the x term that tells us about the variable distance here? If we go to table 3-2 in our text, we can see how to convert from cylindrical to rectangular coordinate systems. Table 3 shows us that x is equal to r cosine of phi, y is equal to r sine of phi, and z is equal to z. Now, all of these are source terms, so what I'm going to be looking for here are source terms, and what I'm going to be plugging in are xs, ys, and zs, which are going to find through this conversion. So this is going to be rs, phi s, and zs. Well, rs is a, so this is as cosine of phi s, and this is equal to as sine of phi s, and this is just equal to zs. So let's plug it in up here. This is equal to as cosine of phi s, as sine of phi s, and zs. Let's suppose that I want to find the electric field out here on the y-axis. This is the electric field point that I'm interested in. So I can just write my rp as 0 in the x direction plus yp in the y direction plus 0 in the zp direction. Then I'm going to find my rsp by taking rp minus rs, just as I did before. Rp minus rs is going to be minus as cosine of phi s in the x direction plus yp minus as sine of phi in the y direction minus zs in the z direction. The magnitude of rsp is simply going to be taking all of these pieces and squaring them. And taking the square root. The unit vector rsp is found by taking the vector rsp and dividing by its magnitude. Now, in order to find the electric field, I'm going to do the same thing I did before. I'm going to take rho s, multiply it by ds over 4 pi epsilon, magnitude squared, unit vector. Let's go to the next slide, the next piece of the lecture, and see how this fits together.